क्वेश्चन फोर, ग्रोथ ऑफ पॉलन ट्यूब टुवर्ड्स ओव्यूल इज कॉल्ड फोटोट्रॉपिज्म, जियोट्रॉपिज्म, हाइड्रोट्रॉपिज्म एंड कीमोट्रॉपिज्म. वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, एवरीबडी शुड गिव द करेक्ट आंसर. ग्रोथ ऑफ पॉलन ट्यूब, यू हैव टू टेल द ट्रॉपिक मूवमेंट हियर. फोटोट्रॉपिज्म, जियोट्रॉपिज्म, हाइड्रोट्रॉपिज्म और कीमोट्रॉपिज्म. सो हियर आर योर आंसर, ऑप्शन नंबर डी. लेट्स गो फॉर द एक्सप्लेनेशन. कीमोट्रॉपिज्म, कीमोट्रॉपिज्म मीन्स मूवमेंट ऑफ द प्लांट बॉडी टूवर्ड्स केमिकल्स. सो इफ वी सी द स्ट्रक्चर, वी विल सी दिस इज स्टिग्मा, स्टाइल एंड ओवरी. सो दिस पॉलन ट्यूब दैट इज एंटरिंग इन साइड, इट विल मूव टूवर्ड्स द ओव्यू, दैट इज फॉर द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन. So there is a chemical that is released by ovule, and this chemical will attract the pollen tube toward itself. So the movement of plant body or plant body part towards the chemical is known as chemotropism. Other option does not suit. Moving to the leaderboard once again, that what are your scores? Let us see. Okay, so Surya is with 3597 point. Let us move to another question. Question number 5. Which statement is incorrect about auxins? You have to tell the false statement about the hormone auxin. They promote the growth of root, they promote the growth of shoot, they influence the formation of flower and ripening of fruit, and option number 4 is they inhibit the growth of root. Four options are there, still 15 seconds are left. Incorrect about auxins. Please see the question properly. Most of you have given wrong answer. Okay, let us discuss the answer. They inhibit the growth of root. This is correct. Incorrect. You have to choose incorrect one. So they will not inhibit, they will promote shoot and root growth. Auxin is a growth promoter and it will promote the growth.
Ma'am, but mentees say that A is the correct option.
So maybe there is some problem.
Relax, Achalji, just go and check in the mentee what is the option bar. Which option is
the thing in front?
Relax.
They will promote the growth of fruit, but in the opposite case.
Okay, the question is, the question is, relax. Atulji, you are moving to the leaderboard. Relax. Atulji, go back to the question, please. Thank you. Thank you. Relax. The question is, which statement is incorrect about auxins? Atulji, can you please re-explain that? Some students have doubt in that. Please re-explain.
See, incorrect means what is not correct, that is false. So they inhibit the growth of root. Actually, auxin is a growth promoter. It's not a growth inhibitor. So the meaning of promoter is that they will promote the root and shoot development. But here it is written they will inhibit. So this is not correct. So the correct answer will be option number 4. If you remember, we have discussed in class growth promoter and growth inhibitor. This will be correct when we will say which is the excessive auxin, that is the hormonal regulation.
Exactly. Achalji, one second. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
So actually, your explanation is correct. Okay. The answer marked, okay, is wrong. Clear?
Okay.
Okay, guys. I'll request. Can this be excused? Because for the first time, her going back and editing like I do that on spot will be a problem. Okay? Please. Sure. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the understanding. Achalji, please proceed. No problem. Clear to them.
Okay, sir.
No problem. Very easy, comfortable. Yeah, please proceed. Please proceed. Please proceed.
So let us move to another question. I hope it is visible, it's going to visible. Question number 6. The waste materials in plant are stored in the form of option A is water, option 2 is gums and resins, option 3 is minerals, and option 4 is sugar. Waste material in plant is stored in the form of. Twelve seconds are left. Time is up. Option B is the correct answer, and most of you have given the correct answer. Let me explain. See, gums and resins, they are the excretory products that is stored in the vacuole, and vacuole is the excretory organ of the plant cell, and by the help of vacuole they will come out, and they are very much economically useful for the human mankind. Water, mineral and sugar is a, you can say it is a, in the form of glucose molecule, so it is not a waste material. Mineral is also not a waste material, and water is present almost for more than 40% in plants, so it's also not a waste material. So option is second, that is the correct. Let us see the leaderboard. So Aryan Tandon with 5,459 points. Okay, next question. Which is the correct sequence of air passage during inhalation? Inhalation means breathe in. We are talking about inspiration. That is the first step of breathing in respiration. You have four options along with the arrows. You have to choose the correct sequence of the passage of air. Nostrils, larynx, pharynx, trachea, lungs, nasal passage, trachea, pharynx, larynx, and alveoli. Larynx, nostrils, pharynx, lungs, trachea, nostrils, pharynx, larynx, trachea, or alveoli. Try to learn the diagram of lung, then you will get the answer. Option D. Most of the students have given that answer. Now let me explain it. If we see the respiratory system, so it will be like this. By the help of the diagram, you will understand also. Here is the nostrils. So moving towards the nose, that have the nostrils. Then here will be pharynx, that is a respiratory, common respiratory as well as digestive organ. After this, there will be larynx, that is known as voice box. Then trachea, this that is known as windpipe, and in the last lungs, and then alveoli. So this is the correct. What happened, Adit? So this is the correct answer. I hope everybody understood. So let us see the leaderboard once again. First RN, Purav, and then Surya. This is the sequence. Moving toward the next question. Choose the form in which most plants absorb nitrogen. Plant want nitrogen, that is a macronutrient. So option you have four. And then there is four option for this, that which one is correct. So protein, nitrate, nitrite, urea, atmospheric nitrogen. So the option first and third, second and third, third and fourth, and one and four. Time is up. Option B. So this one, 2 and 3, that is nitrite, nitrate, and urea. So urea, everybody know we used to give to our plants so that they can have better growth, and in environment they will absorb nitrites and nitrates. So these two are not the correct. So let's see about the leaderboard. So you can see the leaderboard, it's visible also. Moving to the next question. The main thinking part of the brain is forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain, or medulla oblongata. Thinking part of the brain, forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain, or medulla oblongata. Already we have done in class. time is going to finish. Thinking part of the brain. Most of you have given the correct answer. Forebrain. If we move to the question, this one. This forebrain is also known as prosencephalon. This part of the brain, that is, if we make the diagram, so it is like this. Here will be medulla oblongata. Now it's clearly visible. So this anterior part is known as forebrain. This is also known as prosencephalon. It will deal with the activities like thinking, reasoning, memory, and intelligence. So this was about the explanation. Let's go to the next question. Activities like walking in a straight line, riding a bicycle, picking up a pencil are controlled by, you have to once again go with the brain part, cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata, or spinal cord. Cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata, or spinal cord. Balancing activity, here is asking in the question, riding a bicycle, picking up a pencil, moving in a straight line, or walking in a straight line. Very easy question. Okay, so let's go for the explanation once again. Cerebellum is the second part after cerebrum. It is cerebellum only that will help in the balancing of the activity. All the balancing function, either you are moving on the road in a correct way or not, picking up a pencil, then riding a bicycle, riding a car, riding a scooty, whatever. So all the balancing activities are done by cerebellum. Medulla oblongata, brainstem, they are going to, brainstem have a important role in breathing, controlling the breathing rate or respiration. Spinal cord is a cord like structure, so it's never be the answer. So the correct option is cerebellum. So most of you have given the correct answer. Moving towards the leaderboard, let us see the score. Question number 11, the element required for the thyroid gland to make thyroxine hormone is this. Last year also I have discussed, I remember when you were in 9th, calcium, phosphorus, iodine or magnesium. Calcium, phosphorus, iodine and magnesium. Development of thyroid gland so that they can make more and more thyroxine. Time is up. See? Iodine is the only element that is needed to be present in the water or whatever food that a person is having, so that the thyroid gland that is present in the neck region they can release more and more thyroxin. And just because of the more and more thyroxin, there will be development in the body. So these all are not going to be related with the thyroxin hormone. So leaderboard is here. Next question we are going to see on our screen is, which of the following statement is or are true? Sudden action in response to something in the environment is called reflex action. Sensory neuron carry signals from spinal cord to muscles. Motor neurons carry signal from receptors to spinal cord. The path through which signals are transmitted from a receptor to a muscle or a gland is called reflex arc. Four option, 1 and 2 is correct, or 1 and 3 is correct. So sudden action in response to something is known as sudden word is given. So action would be the path by which the messages are going to travel from one part of the neuron to another part and then to the organ of response is known as reflex arc. Sensory neuron will carry the signals from spinal cord to muscles. This is not correct. This is also not correct. So those who have picked answer 3, that is correct. 1 and 4 is correct. Moving to the next question, adrenal glands are located above these organs. I hope the question is visible. Adrenal glands are located above these organs: kidney, lung, stomach, intestine. Four options are there: kidney, lung, intestine and stomach. Very easy question this is. The answer is hidden in the word adrenal gland. So most of you have given the correct answer. Kidney, everybody know, is a bean-shaped structure. And this kidney are 2 in number in case of human being. And above this kidney, there is a triangular-shaped gland that is known as adrenal gland that will release the hormone adrenaline. So this was the explanation. Very easy question. See this question? What is the correct direction of flow of electrical impulse? You have to see this carefully because I hope you will give me the correct answer. Neurons are there, two neurons, and you have to choose the direction. See carefully. Correct direction of flow of electrical impulses. Time is up. Okay, so people are confused in two options, A and C. C is the correct answer. Now let me explain you this one. If you remember, I have told you when we have discussed the structure of the nerve cell that there are two nerve cells. So there is a gap, that is synapse. So always remember, suppose this is a nerve cell having the axon and ending. So this, let me choose red color. So the electrical signals that is in the form of nerve impulses are moving like this, then they will reach to the axon ending, and then there is a synapse, and then they will move to the dendrites of another. So option 3 is correct. Axon ending will give the messages to the dendrites, and that is the correct sequence. And other three does not have this sequence. So option 3 is correct. This is the leaderboard. Aryan, Sneha, and then Aditi. Question number 15. You have to choose the correct match. Column 1, column 2. I hope is also easy, but don't get confused because there are four options and you have to see the options correctly on the board. So don't waste your time. Choose the correct match: phloem, nephron, veins, and platelets. Time is going to finish. Option A. Okay, so let us see. Phloem is going to deal with the translocation of food. Nephron, filter that will help in excretion. So B is P. Veins will carry the deoxygenated blood, and platelets will help in blood clotting. So this is the correct sequence. Any doubt? So this question was from Life Processes. Very easy question. Moving to the next question. Screen is visible. Here also you have to choose column 1, column 2 is there. autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, digestion in food vacuoles. All the four options. This is from Life Processes. Everybody should know this answer. Option number B. So let us see. So autotrophic nutrition is for green plants. Heterotrophic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, let us see first leech, digestion in food vacuole paramecium, then the last we get the deer, heterotrophic nutrition. So this was very easy, doesn't need much of the explanation. Yes, yes, from next time I will take care, you will get enough time for these questions. Next question, please focus. Consider the following statements. There are two statements, A and B. Herbivore is an animal that feeds on both plants and animals. Egestion is the process of passing out undigested component of food. Which of these statements are correct? A only, B only, both A and B, neither A nor B. This is very easy. I don't think so this you will get confused or need a little more time. Time is up. Let's go for the explanation. Consider which of this are correct. So B only, because egestion, everybody know, exit of food material. Which type of food material? Something that is undigested. Herbivore is an animal that feeds on both. No, it should be omnivores. So B is the correct. Moving to the next question, but let us see the leaderboard. What is the score? Everybody look towards your screen. Consider the following statements. Forebrain is the center of intelligence, control, movement and hearing. Control and coordination are function of nervous and endocrine system. Which of this statement is or are correct? A only, B only, both A and B, neither A nor B. Everybody should give the correct answer, because we have already discussed today only, we have discussed in this come on only few things we have discussed. Forebrain is the center of intelligence, and then control coordination, second point. Option C. Let us see. Forebrain, I have told you when I was discussing pros and cephalon that they will responsible, they are for intelligence, memory, reasoning, movement, hearing. And when we go with option B, control and coordination is done by both nervous as well as endocrine system. This is slow and this is fast. So both A and B. Pros and cephalon is the another name of forebrain. PROSCENCEPHALON. Yeah, correct, Momita. So let us see the leaderboard. What are your score? Surya is now at the last. Sneha, Aditi, RNR. Okay, Sneha. Yeah, cerebellum have also another name, mesencephalon. Question number 19. Consider the following statements. Oh, it's Adit. Okay, sorry. Screen is frozen. Hello.
Yes, Achal ji, please.
Sorry, screen time up ho gaya.
No, it's visible. Time's up. 34 people answered it right.
Okay. So, sir, screen pe dikh raha tha kyunki phone pe to dikh hi nahi raha tha.
No problem. At times se hota hai, but yes, I can see it. No worry.
So, let's go for the explanation. Question number 18, and this was immediate response to stimulus is shown by mimosa pudica. Correct. Stems are positively geotropic. No. While roots are negatively geotropic. No. So this B statement is not correct. A is correct. Mimosa pudica is also touch me not. So next question we are going to start just question number 20. Consider the following statements. Excretion is the filtration under pressure of small particles, solute and solvent through a finely porous membrane. Anaerobic respiration is a stepwise complete oxidative breakdown of respiratory substrate into carbon dioxide and water with the help of oxygen that acts as a terminal oxidant. Which of the statement is or are correct? Statement A is correct only. Statement B is correct only. Both is are correct. Both are wrong. This is also easy, but common sense, read, time is up. Option D. Okay. Let me go. Neither A nor B. Excretion is a filtration under pressure. First of all, during excretion, there is nothing like pressure. Okay. Anaerobic respiration stepwise complete oxidative. Why it is oxidative when it is anaerobic? When it is anaerobic, it is due to lack of oxygen. Yeah, very good, Anish. It is tubular secretion. Here it should be, here it should not be pressure. And here anaerobic and oxidative, these both are completely opposite. So both the statements are wrong. So this is the correct option. Let us go to the leaderboard. So finally, Purav, 16,105 points, NPS RNR. Congratulations. Everybody can see your score. After Purav, there is Neha, then RN. Okay. So this is for today. Congratulations, Purav. The questions were easy. First question, they got messed up, and one more with wrong answer. Is it visible? I can see the screen. It's visible. So very thank you to all of you. Thank you. Thank you, Aditi. Okay, so bye-bye. Take care, everybody. Congratulations, Pura.